Hello, my name is Dusty Kurt, and I'm an energy healing practitioner and body worker. So I'm a licensed massage therapist here in Oregon.
And Amber is an energy healing practitioner, and that's pretty much all I do, which is a lot of stuff, actually. But that's it, energy healing practitioner. What we want to do today is talk about support systems. So support people and support avenues to get you through your self evolution and healing process. And it should be an adventure. It should be fun. But we need to have a certain space where we can play with each other. You know, we can't be boring about this. We have to have things that we can do. So for instance, Dusty and I are both healers, but we play off of each other a lot of times with clients because, like for instance, I might have herbals that she doesn't have, and we'll just go back and forth with that. Or, you know, I might have a client, or she might have a client that says, you know, they want to learn how to do horseback riding, like horse equine therapy. And I'm like, well, do you know somebody who's either a professional or somebody who's just has horses and knows how to teach people how to ride? And so we'll just work back and forth with that sort of thing. Or, for instance, maybe there's somebody that is just afraid of almost everything. But they have an obsession with alpacas. You never know. And so I don't know anyone who has alpacas. So I'll call Dusty or I'll call somebody else and ask if they know somebody with alpacas that they want a little bit of help grooming them. So all of these things are beautiful therapies. They're beautiful ways to heal. And that's just what we do. We work off of each other and creating a system of healing and a system of help, like a circular type system of it, is really, really important. So again, it's just about creating a space where you can reach out to people. And it's a self-healing process. Like, our entire, I'm gonna talk for Dusty a tiny, tiny bit.
You're talking for me again?
Sorry, can I talk to you about you?
Yeah, you can talk about me.
In like a little tiny bit?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so Dusty and I both, basically our job is to get you to be self-sufficient so that you're looking for your own healing process and finding it and enjoying that space. And so our job is to facilitate a group and a process. And again,
right, which is really empowering, right? So I think it's really about working on empowering individuals to take their own journey in their healing process. And that's where a lot of my work comes in and her work comes in, is it's a lot about self-care. And self-care for your families, self-care for yourself, and that goes on all levels because it doesn't, you know, just come out of a box. It doesn't come off of one program. And it's about working together and working with multiple healers, multiple mentors in your life to create a truly wonderful space in your life, to be vibrant and healthy. You know, they always say that, you know, it takes a tribe to raise a child, but that never ends. We're always children, always learning, right? So that's where I think we really
talk. We're always
redonkulous. Yeah.
Absolutely. But I love the way she said about the box is we do put ourselves in our own box. Like maybe somebody else helped us find the box, but then we stay in that box. And so getting out of it is really important. So again, it could be equine therapy, it could be alpacas, it could be anything. And we just have to go there.
Yeah, so going there. What if you don't know where to start and all you have is a time and space like right now where you're just not feeling you're in your best spot, where you're not feeling your greatest self, where you have low energy, or you're stuck in this rut of being very negative on yourself. And that's kind of where I feel like we come in as energy healers, is we come in and we just help you find your own path and help illuminate that path so that you can walk it yourself and we might push you, not push you, we might like just give you a little bit of extra illumination on this journey, this path for yourself, which might be like sending you to an astrologist. I've sent people to astrologists.
Or hot springs.
Yeah, or hot springs.
Or a movie.
Mm-hmm. Or a movie. Or a hike in the woods.
But all done with spiritual space. So we're basically, our job is to get you tapped into your spirit guides, otherwise called angels, otherwise called, what else? I don't know, there's lots of other words that you would call them depending on what culture you're from, what religion you're from. It doesn't matter. They're basically the people, the beings that are here to try to help oversee you and help you be safe as best as possible and heal and do your path work. Be here in a positive way. So our job is to get you tapped into that work, usually through a pendulum at first, and then it can move into other spaces of using that water, your body, all that kind of stuff. Not getting into that too much today, but our job is to get you into that healing space with your guides so that you have constant companionship, basically, to heal and move forward in your life.
The life source energy runs through everything, right? And there is tons of evidence that everything is made of energy. I mean, scientifically, we're totally made of energy. And in that, when we're talking about boxes, is we put ourselves in these limited belief systems where we keep repeating our history and we keep repeating our past, because that's like what we have conditioned ourselves and other people have conditioned ourselves to be, because we're constantly exposed to it. And in a natural life system, it's open. You know, it's not inside of these boxes. So what we do is really just help expand the box and try to give it different forms and shapes. And now I'm just kind of rambling. But
rambling's good. I like that. Yeah, it's good.
Yeah, and how we do that is through energy healing. Like, and we call it healing, but there's so much more to it than healing. It is a way of life, because we're constantly asking what is best for our energetic being, what is best for our physical being, and what is best for our mental space. And we can do that through the life source energy, because that's what made us even grow into humans. That's what makes this little tiny seed grow into this ginormous tree that can live for thousands and thousands of years. It's that same life force energy. And that's what we help people tap into.
Yeah, it is. It's helping you tap into it. So I want to ask you, what's your favorite way to work with people?
Really, I like giving people a different experience. So taking them out of their space. I like to get them out of their house, even out of my healing studio I work with, out of my house. And just get into nature. And whether that is helping them plant some herbs that are extremely important to their healing process, because it's something that they might need for a longer period of time, or whether it's hiking in the woods and just breathing in the fresh air, because they're from the city, like from Portland or to somewhere where the air is just not the same. And then having those conversations and getting them to realize that it's life. Like, it's not something we just do, it's something that we are. And it's around us, it's everywhere.
Absolutely. Can I answer the same question?
Yeah, you should totally answer the same question. What do you?
That's the only reason I asked you.
Yeah,
so I
was like, so you can answer it. Yeah.
Pretty much the same thing. I love that people are unique and different, and I personally have worked through a lot of stuff myself, and I think all of us, if we haven't, we should, and we're still gonna, like Dusty said, we're still gonna evolve. We're gonna keep doing this. We're gonna keep going. But I love getting out kayaking, horseback riding, hiking, so people can learn how to use their pendulum, their energy work, to check on herbals, you know, do some wildcrafting.
And yeah, just the practical use of the energy,
not checking on your spouse.
Yeah, totally.
God. How about you start taking care of yourself first? Don't be spying on people, okay? All right. So,
like, we know who we're talking to right now.
I'm talking to you right now.
Yeah, we do.
So, yeah, get in there and do some fun stuff, but use it practically, of course. And I also, I like it when other people need certain things I'm not really used to, which I'm used to a lot of stuff and I'm game for it. But, you know, sometimes I get drug into like junkyards because some people like old cars and trucks. And it helps them heal. It helps them remember what they enjoy doing. You know, maybe they wanted to restore that car for a long time and they felt inhibited because somebody told them they shouldn't. You know, things like that. I mean, you never know where it's at and where you're going. But
yes, and that's where the blocks go away and where I feel energy work is really important. Because you can come in for a session or you can come in for an educational experience, which is what I totally prefer. But sometimes we do need to just heal. Like, I get energy sessions from other people because it's time for me to lay down there and just, like,
receive
and let go. Mm. And I also, like, as much body care that we can do for ourselves, I get massage therapy. I go to hot springs because they heal me. I allow that openness of the life system to be able to be fed and to be able to get rid of things that I need and try and participate in that with other people. And participating, thanks to our friends together in this space.
Exactly.
Because so we never would have had this opportunity without having people like this who do wonderful things.
Cruz,
yeah.
I don't know if he wants us to talk about him.
Yeah,
or not,
but he gets to edit it out anyway.
Yeah,
so whatever.
So
Cruz and Luis and people that have all these wonderful expertises, because I love being an energy healer and I absolutely love doing body work and I love art. And we all, no matter who you are, we have art in us. And whether it's filming or pottery or anything, being a mechanic
grooming dogs, mechanics. Absolutely.
That's
something you enjoy that is a creation, it's a type of creation, absolutely. Mm-hmm. In any way. Mm-hmm. And that helps us release into ourselves, into our beautiful space. And if we have sadly we have people that try to hold us down, that are negative, and quite often that happens when you're younger in some form or another, and that's when we start getting these boxes. And we don't want to stay in that box. We want to expand through that space and become who we want to be. And who we want to be will evolve year after year after year, maybe week after week. So,
Right, because I wonder, like, what person today would actually be happy if they were in the same place they were 10 years ago? And there's not very many. Or if I told you today that this is the way your life's going to be the rest of your life. Yeah, we tend to be really afraid of change. And that's I swear it's kind of like this weird human condition.
Right,
but we're also afraid of it being the same thing.
I'm so interjecting right now.
Oh, okay.
So if your favorite thing was your football glory years and you can't get past that, and you have your favorite song, and it's only your favorite song, but you didn't like figure out that there's other favorites too, and you just can't get past that, you probably are stuck somewhere.
Yeah, looping.
It's okay to like enjoy your life after the football or after the cheerleader or after your blue ribbon on your horse, you know, and whatever class that might have been in. You know, it's okay to like keep going and have different avenues of happiness. And that sometimes that includes children for people or a dog or your niecling. I don't know, but you got to keep going forward. If you don't, we stay stuck and we get angry, and that's not cool. Yeah, so we have to move forward. And energy healing and energy work is awesome with that. And Destiny and I both teach you how to work with your spirit guides, how to go forward, because we're just us. We're human. And we only have so much time and space to give to anybody. So if we can teach you how to be with your guides, with your spirit guides, your angels, whatever you want to call them, then you always have a support system. Not that you can't talk to us, but we get you going. So, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I feel like I need to, like, iterate the, like, A lot of people like get this like cringe, I've noticed, but the interest, but also like this little bit of
like
a
scary,
cringe, like this scary, like when you talk about energy healing or that you're an energy healer and they don't know how to react. They don't even, maybe it's because they don't really know what it is sometimes, but a lot of times it's they think that it's kind of creepy or because it's just not in their norm because they have a box, right? Mm-hmm. You know, and so outside of that box is a strange place. And I just like to iterate this, like energy healing is like an action. You know, energy healing is an action, but energy is always, because our stones, our mountains are energy, the water is energy. We even use it to create human energy to put into the light bulbs that light up the studio. But so everything's energy, and it's an extremely natural and organic space. Mm-hmm. It's not creepy. It feels different, but it's not creepy. Yeah, it's not just, like
you know what it is? It's because you don't touch it. You haven't seen it. You haven't been there enough. Some people haven't even had a dream that's not in black and white, you know, or haven't been able to interact within their dreams. They don't know how to. It's simply they're watching a movie, and it might be nice, it might be scary, or they don't even remember. And so all it is getting into that space where you can touch into that. And so we just help you do that, and then it's all yours. You can do whatever you want with it. But if you spend your entire life being afraid of the beauty of this world and of the universe and all of that, it's not good. It creates sickness, creates those boxes, all of those things, so.
Yeah. Right. So, like, did I say that life flourishes in an open system?
You need
did
to say
I
that.
Say that?
You life... need to, like, expand on that idea, because, yeah, you sort of got there, and then, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Say it again. Life expands. Yeah.
Life flourishes
there we go.
In open systems. And we need an open mind and we need an open body, so a functioning body and a very fluid mind.
Open chakras is sort of what she's getting through. It's like chakras, having that,
good movement, but also a fluid mind where we can explore areas that we might not be comfortable with. And then we don't have to go there, but we need to be able to explore them and decide truthfully whether it's other people's idea that we're making our decisions on or if it's what's best for us. Mm-hmm. And we get to do that through having open communication with our mentors and our healers and our educators.
And our spirit guides.
Whether it's, and our spirit guides, mm-hmm. which are great teachers.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So life flourishes in an open system.
Absolutely. Yep. And so, and getting to know your guides and working with your guides is part of that open system. And it also protects you. Now I'm using the word after this open thing. Now I'm going to use the word protection, right? So, but your guides help protect you from silly people. I'm just going to call them silly people. Some of them are negative. Some of them are just wonky. And so you can ask them what the best decision is for you, not for anybody else. What's the best decision for you? And now you're gonna have to use your mind a little bit. It's gonna be deductive reasoning and strategic thought process, if I can get all that out, to work with your guides at first until your window opens, usually through meditation, and you can talk to them a little bit more directly. But that's what we do, basically, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and because we work on a very individual level and we realize that everybody is different and we come from different places. Because even Amber, raised in the same family as me.
We're sisters.
We
might have got that the last name.
Yeah,
same,
with the last name.
You never know.
Stuff,
I mean, there might be a few Kurtz running around.
Yeah. We come from the same place, but we are very different people. Yeah. And anybody with a family probably knows how different people can be coming from the same place. And
yeah,
I totally forgot where I was going with that.
It's all good. Yeah, yeah. I think that it's the idea of owning yourself is really important because, again, like you come from the same family, you come from the same upbringing, come from the same religion, and we still are different people because that's the way we are. That's the way we're made. That's the way we evolve. And so we have to just learn to own that space and do what's best for us, and then we'll be happy as a society, as an individual within the society, and that sort of thing. So,
that's great.
We good?
Okay, but okay. It was the whole, like, why I feel like approaching everybody is, like, differently. Like, I don't have notes when people come over with, like, this whole, like, first we're going to do this, and second we're going to do that, and then we've got this list of things that we're going to go through.
As a healer,
healer,
you don't have that
I don't have that space, mm-hmm. because we all come from different places, and if we don't come from different places, we're still different people. And so it's a very cooperative and collaborative healing experience.
Absolutely.
And sometimes that's daunting for people because they just want to be fixed. I do not fix anybody.
And they want their test.
Yeah, and their test. Yeah.
Like, no.
I don't fix anybody. That's not my job. Thank goodness it's not my
right.
job. I feel like I'm a guide, and I help illuminate paths, like I said before. And that's why everything's different, is because if you need pushed in the direction, because you're asking for it, not because I'm making you do it, but like if you have a phobia and you want to get over your phobia, we're going to do things that help you get over that phobia. We're not going to just stay in this room, in this little really safe space for you. We're going to just like work on expanding that and giving you like a walk in the park if you're afraid of like dirt. And it's totally true. It happens.
It
so
happened.
It's individual. And it's very collaborative. And
yeah, it's all about the group experience to a large degree. And if you want to hide too, sometimes we have to learn how to hide.
Mm-hmm.
Have your own space and then go out and see society when you want to. But first we have to figure out what we are and what we like, and then know how to say what we are and what we like and what we want to do. And energy healing is a body, mind, spirit process if you do it properly, and if other people take it on properly, which is basically self-awareness and taking on your own self as your job. You know, your history, of course, has a lot to do with who you are now, but it doesn't have to define you. You know, it doesn't have to make you a certain thing. And so we need to just figure out how to expand that view of who we are, and that's good.
Yeah.
And I love my sis.
Let me sis too. Yeah.
All right. I think maybe it's a wrap.
Maybe a cut wrap thing.
Okay.
Break.
And one thing I do want to mention is that I love working one-on-one. I usually do. It's actually one of my most favorite places is to work with one individual to learn how to work with their spirit guides and do energy testing on their foods and their medications and their herbals and all that kind of stuff and really get in that space. It works best that way because you're an individual and you learn in a certain way that other people don't learn in. But the other thing I really do enjoy doing, which is a little bit newer, I've been doing this for quite a few years, but I do enjoy working with very small groups. I don't do seminars per se for the most part. I mean, it's not like I don't do a little bit of public speaking, which I guess I'm sort of doing now. Not really. But what I like is on occasions have small groups that have a focus of some sort of like green building. I worked with somebody recently, about four people that were doing gardening in LA on rich people's places. So instead of just palm trees and pretty flowers, they were actually growing food there and bringing that into food banks and things like that. So it also worked as the more rich people's donation process. So that's beautiful. And so when I work with them, I'm still doing the energy work, getting their chakras open, that sort of thing, but also getting them to work with their spirit guides so that they can work more cohesively with themselves as a small group, let's say four or five, something like that. It could be a little bit larger, but they all agree that they cohesively want to work better with each other through their spirit guides, and then also work better with the people they're working with outside of their group. So like the people that have mansions in LA, things like that. So that's really fun. It's exciting and dynamic, and that gives me something new to do, which is exciting. So that's sort of what I do in a nutshell. And Dusty?
So I really enjoy working with actually small groups and individuals as well, because when somebody really wants to learn something, they need special attention, in my opinion. But the thing is I love small groups, and it's individualized to people that have a holistic intention. And like, I worked with a small group a couple weeks ago just on learning how to do tinctures, which, you know, you can find stuff on YouTube and you can read about it as much as you want, but until your hands are on the herbs and you're interacting with the bottles and you're interacting with the people and you're doing this interaction with the things that you're learning about, you don't have that special connection. So I like small groups on those very holistic intentions. And I love the fact that you worked with some permaculturists, because
it's a really great thing.
So I don't have any events planned. I'm sure there will be some coming up because they are fun, but individuals and small groups, you can find it on our, you know, information.
Yeah, I think in general, like, if you want a small event, then we can do small events with the intentional groups that you have an intention already. You know, it's like we're not making the intention. Not that we don't have a little bit going on here or there, that sort of thing. But yeah, it's normally somebody that's already somewhat into the space and then want a group activity. So.
Right, exactly. You can schedule a group activity type thing.
There we go.
Yeah.
That's it.
And I just want to say thank you so much for listening to us and hanging out with us, and hopefully something sparked your interest, or there's that little seed that's going to grow and have you even explore more things.
Yeah, so. Absolutely. Yeah, so, yeah, thanks for wasting your time with us. Just kidding. No, it wasn't a waste of time. So, yeah, have a great day. Love you.
Hear me when I need to be heard. How deep is your rain?